Rain wasn't in the forecast that day, so Adrian was a little surprised to find the sky weeping when he exited the school. It must have just started because he didn't recall seeing or hearing it during his last class. He looked up at the sky lumbering with thick gray clouds. He had taken note of the distant clouds that morning when he woke to a dark and gloomy room, but against better judgment, he didn't grab an umbrella. At least he only had a short distance from the school to the car to worry about. Adrian gripped the strap to his bag and prepared to make the dash to the car when a shadow loomed over him. He looked up to see a pink umbrella hovering over his head and turned to his left to see Marinette looking at him curiously before a smile stretched on her face. "I'll walk you," she said without a trace of a stutter. They had known each other for almost 2 years now as they were nearing the end of their first year in high school. While Adrian was still near and dear to her heart, Marinette no longer had the resolution to pursue him. There was just too much going on in her life, and she no longer had the luxury to consider a romance. It was a damn shame, though, she thought wryly. The time that passed had done Adrian well. He had grown taller, but even when Marinette had heeled boots on, she seemed pitifully short. His features had become sharper, losing some of the baby fat he had in his cheeks. Most of it had happened during the last summer, and she found herself flabbergasted by the drastic change that occurred over the span of 2 months. Handsome was an understatement, as everyone perpetually fawned over him. But despite all that, he still carried in him a sort of brightness and innocence that reminded Marinette of sunshine. "Thanks," Adrian couldn't help but return Marinette's smile. There was something about it that always managed to cheer him up. Even though both of their best friends were dating each other, forcing him and Marinette together more often, he wasn't as close to her as would be expected. She was fun to be around, he gathered as much from the few times they did hang out together. He would have liked to learn more about one of his first friends, but their schedules always seemed to conflict with one another. His schedule still consisted of the usual modeling and lessons, but Marinette had become busier, becoming more involved with fashion designing and helping out at the bakery. Adrian inwardly sighed when they reached the car. He was so busy with his thoughts that their 30 seconds together went by in silence. He spared her a grateful glance as she shifted the umbrella when he opened the car door so that it wouldn't get wet inside. Before entering, Adrian looked at his phone to check the time. He still had an hour before piano lessons and looked up at her expectantly. "I could ask Gorilla to give you a ride," Adrian said, hoping that she'd accept. He had to admit that he was craving some sort of friendly attention. He and Nino still hung out, but since the latter had gotten a girlfriend, they didn't hang out as much as they used to. Marinette's eyes shifted to the left as she looked into the distance in the direction of her home. She missed the days of living next to school and found that she had to put extra effort into making it to school on time. She became a little better at balancing her civilian life with the superhero one, making fewer slip-ups as she got more experience living her double life. A sigh passed her lips when she thought of her eventual patrol in the rain that night. She turned her eyes back to him, happy that he offered. "It's all right, it's not that far of a walk," Marinette said, eyes looking wistful. She liked walking in the rain, under the sound of the droplets hitting her umbrella. It was calm and soothing, and it reminded her of the day she fell in love for the first time. She liked to relish in that feeling, as the responsibility of being Ladybug didn't give her a chance to dwell on her romantic life. Adrian was disappointed, but he didn't press her. He didn't want to seem too needy, too clingy. Marinette was finally feeling more comfortable around him, and he didn't want to do anything to jeopardize that. It was irrational thinking since he knew Marinette was too kind to be put off by something like that. But just the small possibility of it was enough to place the fear of being rejected into his heart. So he just nodded and smiled. A trill voice pulled them both out of their gazes at each other, and Marinette felt her body being shoved roughly. Adrian's eyes widened as she lost her balance and quickly grabbed her arm before she could fall to the wet ground. Unfortunately, her umbrella had flown out of her hand from the impact, and the rain came pouring down on her. He, on the other hand, was under the protection of the offender's umbrella, although he was feeling that he'd much rather get wet than be under the same umbrella as Chloe at the moment. Chloe briefly glanced at Marinette with a satisfied and smug glint in her eyes before she turned her attention back to Adrian. He gave her an exasperated frown, displeased with the way she treated Marinette, but she paid it no mind. "I just wanted to remind you that my birthday party is this Saturday," Chloe said. Adrian was annoyed by the sheer fact that she had barged in between him and Marinette only to tell him something that he already knew. Her unrelenting dislike for Marinette had clearly grown even more as they aged, and he found it childish and unattractive. It was a shame. Chloe would be a pretty girl if her personality wasn't so off-putting most of the time. "Chloe, that was rude," Adrian sighed and narrowed his eyes at her. But that was the extent of his scolding. Even though he became fed up with her often, he couldn't bring himself to say much against her. She was his oldest friend, and somewhere deep inside of him, he clung on to the memories of the happy little girl that smiled brightly whenever they played together. Chloe didn't seem to give a hoot about his words. She just rolled her eyes and told him not to be late before walking towards her own ride. As his unwanted protection from the rain walked off, the rain began to pelt against his body. He let out another sigh and turned to Marinette. Marinette just stared at him before her eyes flitted over to her umbrella. Adrian then realized that he was still holding her arm, preventing her from retrieving it. His face flushed and he quickly let her go. "Sorry," he apologized, but she just brushed it off with a laugh. She grabbed her umbrella and shook it before bringing it back up over their heads. "Well, so much for that, huh? You ended up getting wet anyway," Marinette smiled sheepishly. "I'm really sorry about that. You wouldn't have gotten wet if you didn't walk me." Adrian looked genuinely upset, and Marinette's heart clenched, thinking that he was just so endearingly sweet. "Don't apologize, it's not your fault. We all know Chloe just finds me so irresistible that she can't keep her hands off of me," Marinette joked, hoping that it'd bring his smile back. Adrian blinked and stared at her for a good bit before bursting out in laughter. The warmth in her chest rose and spread to her cheeks as she listened to him. His laughter was truly music to her ears. When his laughter died down, he inhaled and caught his breath. "See you tomorrow," a gentle smile stretched across his face, and he bid her goodbye before turning and entering the car. Marinette raised a hand and waved, feeling a sense of deja vu. "See you tomorrow." But this time, she managed to get her words out.